Have a great day. Fred. Huh. Look at her. What? Candace!
What?
What do you think you're doing? I'm putting things on a shelf. No! What's wrong with putting things on a shelf? You could hurt yourself. Here, I'll do it for you. Okay, so then what do? You could walk around and greet people. No, she can't do that. She might bump into a corner. Good point, good point. Which reminds me, we should really baby-proof the corners. Twins wouldn't even be able to reach the corners until they're walking. Oh, it's not for the twins, it's for you. You're pretty clumsy, Candace. Okay, so then what do? You could sit behind the cash register. No, but the door might hit her stomach and we don't want that. Good point, George. Good thinking. I'm done.
I'm up. I'm up. I told you to go up 10 minutes ago. You're going to be late now. Pansy?
Why else is it going to be coming into your dorm room?
My dorm room?
Has someone obliterated you? What is wrong with you?
What's she doing? Oh, you're still in bed. How is she still in bed? We told you to get up like 20 minutes ago, Alicia. Wake up. Daphne?
A Gryffindor's definitely psyched her something. Look, she's out of it. Think she won't get Snape.
Maybe we should just leave her. No, don't go and get Snape. I'll just get ready. This is mine, right?
Of course it's yours. It's on your bed. Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine. I'll see you guys in a couple of minutes.
Okay, just meet us in 10 at the Great Hall. We'll be with the boys. I need to ask Draco about the homework.
Draco.
I'll reach my hands out in the dark and wait for yours to interlock.
On a pussy hole.
Dad. Why is everyone staring at me?
You just called Captain Holt Dad. You said thanks, Dad.
What? No, I didn't. I said thanks, man.
Do you see me as a father figure, Peralta?
No. If anything, I see you as a bother figure, because you're always bothering me.
Hey, show your father some respect.
I didn't call him Dad.
No. Jacob. I take it as a compliment.
It's not a big deal. I called Vivian Mom once, and she's my fiance.
Guys! Jump on that! Boyle has psychosexual issues.
Old news, but you calling Holt Daddy.
Hey, Daddy is not on the table here.
But you did call him Dad, dude.
You shut up. You've done nothing but lie since you got here.
All right, I was lying about the holdup. But the Dad thing, that happened.
Aha! He admitted that his alibi was a lie. It was a trap. All part of my crazy, devious plan.
I believe you.
Thank you.
Son, you want to talk about it later over a game of catch?
I'd like that.
How my sorting ceremony went in my DR? The sorting hat sings its song. When I call your name, you will put on the hat and sit on the stool to be sorted. Abbott, Hannah. Oh shit, that means I have to go next, Hufflepuff. Oh my god, is that George sitting out there? Fuck, fuck, fuck. George sees me looking at him and gives me a thumbs up. Fuck, he saw me looking. Somebody Avada Kedavra me, please. Abbott, Julia, fuck. Ravenclaw gets up to go sit at the Ravenclaw table and deadass trips on my robes. sits next to a third year named Roger Davies. Wow, did it hurt when you fell? Winks. Oh my fucking god.
I don't care what you say, I know one thing, so they all love you like I do.
Say we're just friends, but I swear when nobody's around.
You guys will never believe it. I came up with another cool new shifting method. This one's specifically for Hogwarts. So if you're going to Hogwarts, listen up. I was going to show a visual of what I'm trying to say, but look at this.
Hello?
Okay, if it loads, I'll show you. If it doesn't, I'm sorry. Basically, I don't know what to call this. If you want to come up with another name for it, let me know. But basically, if you've watched the Goblet of Fire Harry Potter movie, you know when they all go into the maze for like the third part of the like Triwizard tournament? Yeah, so a shifting method could be you walk into the maze from your CR, and then it closes behind you, like the vines like seal, and then you walk throughout the maze, getting closer and closer to your DR, and then once you get to the middle, the cup is still there, and it's a port key, and then you hold the port key, and it takes you to your DR. I think that's so cool, and that would work really well for people who are good at visualizing. I had to look up the scene on YouTube, but this is what I'm talking about.
Here is a first day of fifth year. Story time.
Have you guys seen Alessia? The train's gonna leave you and she's not even here, so.
Do we honestly care that much? Shut up, Pansy. She's been through a lot this summer.
Hi.
Hi. Why weren't you on the platform?
My mum wanted me to put my robes on before I got on the train this year.
Oh, alright. Alessia, have you changed your hair?
Yep, you know, post-breakup, change everything about yourself.
Do you mind if I just set my bag up in the compartment?
Sorry.
You look different.
Yeah, it's because of the breakup.
You look good.
Thanks.
We need to speak when we get back to the school.
Okay.
Hey, what do you think your name would be if it wasn't Draco? Why did you say it like that? Just answer the question. I don't know. I guess... Tom.
Tom?
Mm-hmm. You look like a Tom. Tom. Nah, it's too plain.
Plain?
Yeah. I think... Score... No!
Oh, man.
She don't know what she's doing.
She don't know what she's doing.
Yeah, she does. She knows exactly what she's doing.
Yeah, it's gonna...
Okay, so literally one person said they wanted a story time. So I guess like the first thing that was funny is that the night before the Quidditch World Cup, I fell asleep on the couch because I was so tired. So George was the one who woke me up at like 4 in the morning because we had to leave early. So he wakes me up by like violently shaking me and screaming, "Fire, fire!" So I wake up and I'm panicking because I'm like, oh my god, the burrow's on fire. So I get up, I'm like looking around, I'm like, there's no fire. And Fred is in the background behind George eating porridge and he's so fucking pissed. That's another thing. George is a morning person, Fred is not a morning person. So Fred's like, that's how he woke me up too. He was so mad. And George like thought it was so fucking funny. George was like, ah, I got you both. And me and Fred were just like, what the fuck? And literally Molly was mad too because like Fred apparently woke up screaming and woke up Molly. And like the whole entire house was just so pissed off. It was so funny.
The fire in the hay. The fire in the hay.
Girl I've ever seen in my entire life.
Excuse me?
Dude, I can't even describe her. She was just so, like, oh my god.
Do you know what you're saying to me right now?
Dude, come on, I have to show you. I have to show you her. Come here.
No, what the? I don't want to see this girl.
Yes, you do. Come here, come here. Look, look. She's right there.
Wow, very funny, Draco.
Michaela, wake up. Wake up.
It's 1 a.m. Why are you waking me up?
I have to show you something. Come on.
Oh my god.
Draco, why are we outside and it's freezing?
Here, take my jacket.
Thank you.
Why do you have this blanket here? Oh my god, you're an absolute idiot. Come over here and lay down next to me.
Okay, but what are we doing?
We're watching the stars.